Hey, it's me! So today, as you can tell from the title, we are going to be doing some makeup. I know, it's been a long ass time since I've done some makeup on this channel, but I had a little bit of an idea. So what I want to do is I want to start a series where I create different makeup looks that are inspired by people's dance regalias, or even like ribbon skirts and ribbon shirts, things like that. What I would like to focus mostly on would be powwow regalias. So yeah, I want to start off this series by using my own regalia and doing a makeup look inspired by that. And let's get started. So I'm gonna go ahead and just prime my eyes with some concealer. Now my regalia has like a bluish, silver, white, purplish kind of moment. My inspiration was to be like an icy queen type. I wanted people to be cold just by looking at me. All right, so here I got this Life's a Drag palette by Lunar Beauty. And what I'm going to do is take Fishy on actually the brush that came with the palette. I totally didn't even mean to do that. Like, I grabbed the brush and then I grabbed the palette. Anyway, I'm going to be taking the fluffier side of the Lunar Beauty brush, and I'm going to apply this in the crease, slowly building up the color. Alright, this is some good glue. Okay, so I'm going to take just the tiniest little bit of Pageant Queen on the smaller side here. I don't know why I'm showing you how to do it. It's not like you're going to recreate this or anything. I just want to like add some of that purple color right here. So I guess I should talk about like what inspired me to do this experiment, right? Alright, before I get there, I'm just going to keep using the same brush. I got this little swirl. Alright, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to take Shady and I'm going to pop that like on the outer corner. So what inspired me to do this was I was watching a YouTuber that I subscribe to, and she is an Indian woman. Not like us, like Eastern, like from India. She had posted a video where she was sharing like a makeup look and jewelry look, an inspiration of Eid. And I just thought, oh, I should do that, but like powwow. Like, here's a makeup look that you can wear to the powwow. And yeah, the more I thought about it, the more I was like, well, that's not gonna work just cause I feel like people already kind of have their routine down if they're a dancer and they have like all the regalia and everything. I feel like everybody has their own kind of routine with how they put their regalia on, how they do their hair, and how they do their makeup. So I wasn't really sure if posting looks for you to wear, yeah, I think that was gonna work because I feel like everybody already kind of has their look that they go to. And another one, I feel like, and this is myself included, like most of the time if you're seeing people wear makeup and regalia, it'll be like a base and maybe some brown in the crease, like not a whole lot, very minimal, and that's how I do it too. So yeah, that really turned me off the idea of those thoughts there. Well, why don't I create looks like inspired from the color palette of regalia. So yeah, here we are. I want to make this like kind of like a series that never ends. Like, there's so many regalias out there and so many different looks that you can do, so many different colors and combinations of colors that I look forward to making more of these. It's not going to be like a what's the word I'm thinking of? It's not gonna be like a consistent thing, you know, like I'll do one next week and the week after that, especially right now because we are nearing the middle of June. So that means that powwow season in my area is really gonna be kicking off. And your girl wants to go to some and vlog them. I would love to see if like some native makeup artists can weigh in on this little experiment I'm doing here too, because there's a couple, and I mean, like, I'll put a couple on the screen right here. I hate how shit looks different on the camera than it does in real life, because, like, I can see, like, a nice little bit of purple underneath the blue right there, but I can't really see it on the camera. That's bullshit. This camera's anti-native. Bugs! Stop it! Yeah, I'm gonna try and add a little more of that purple. This is driving me nuts. I was trying to add it very lightly. Because, like, once you add color, you can't take it away. But I couldn't see it. I feel like I need a fluffier brush. Let's try this guy here. Just a clean, fluffy brush. Oh, why does my left eye always turn out better than my right eye? Like, do y'all see it? It's better. It's this. Alright, so now I'm going to cut the crease. Alright, so I think that's good enough. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to dig into my Riviera palette by Anastasia, and I'm going to take Seaside here. It's kind of like, I don't know how to describe it. It's kind of like silvery with bluish undertones. I really like it. Always better with the finger, I swear. There we go. Look at that. Woo! I admire people who are able to swipe eyeshadow on their lid and not mess with it for several minutes straight. That's not me. I'm gonna take a little bit of that blue fishy color and just press it very lightly right here and try and connect the shimmer to the black. So we're missing some purple. I feel like this is a very blue eye look. Do I want to do a purple under eye or a purple liner? Do I want to take the easy way out or do the hard way? Let's go for the purple liner. Okay, so I have this NYX liquid lipstick here. This is Liquid Suede in the shade Amethyst? Amethyst? I don't know, I don't speak English. Whew, all right. That was an adventure. It was kind of hard to do eyeliner with a brush that is just not thin enough. So I'm actually just going to take a little bit of Pageant Queen here, and I'm going to lightly press that over top of the lipstick. Figured it would set it in place, but it's actually making it just a tad more vibrant. It's cool. So I'm going to take that shady on an angled brush and put that on the under eye. I've been using Fishy here, but I'm actually going to take some Kiki. I'm going to use that. Does anybody else have to make this face when they do this? I do, just because my under eyes are wrinkly because I'm old. So I'm almost done here. I think what I'm going to do now is I'm going to take the Anastasia Aurora palette, and I want to highlight the inner corner and underneath the brow. So feeling like this is still kind of blue, so in order to incorporate a little more of the purple, I'm going to take some Spectra and blind some people. I can just not capture it on the camera. Like, so this is like super bright white light. Mm.
Okay.
So here is the finished look. I think I succeeded in wrapping up all the colors that go along with my regalia. We have some blue, some purple, some black, white, and like silvery reflective look. So I want to inspire you to get at me on Twitter and Instagram and send me a picture of you in your regalia, and I want to try and recreate that color palette but on my eyes. So yeah, I hope you like this. I hope you want to see more from me in this little series, or more from me in general. I hope this was entertaining or whatever you want it to be, and I'll see you in the next one.